The parish community of St. Mary wishes to extend a warm welcome to all who come to worship here with us, especially all visitors. This weekend, we celebrate Easter Sunday. The Easter collection supports the retirement, medical, and financial needs of priests in good standing throughout the Archdiocese of Boston. These priests have given their lives to faithfully serve Christ, the Church, and you. No. Please be generous with this important collection. We thank you very much for your generosity. The St. Joseph Spring Fundraiser will take place on Thursday, May 19th at Jones River Trading Post. If you have a donation item or experience for the silent auction, please contact the parish office. For more details on sponsorship opportunities and purchasing tickets, please visit the parish website. We look forward to seeing you there.
Good morning. Happy Easter.
Please stand and greet our celebrant, Father Antonio, and please join in singing our opening hymn, number 176 in your Breaking Bread issue, Jesus Christ is Risen Today, number 176. Jesus Christ is risen today. Alleluia. Our triumphant holy day. Alleluia. Who did once upon the
Good morning, people of God. Happy Easter. Today is a beautiful day in the celebration of our faith because it's the day who gives the reason, the fundamentation to our faith. Christ is risen. Alleluia, alleluia. Welcome, all of you. Let us start our Holy Mass. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. And as we know, our Father is so merciful. Let us ask for the forgiveness of our sins. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to the everlasting life. Amen. And now, since we are forgiven, illuminated by God, let us lit the candle, the Easter candle, the signal of the victory of Jesus upon death and upon sin, that is our victory too. Christ, light of the world, thanks be to God. Let us try again. Christ, light of the world, thanks be to God. And with happiness, let us sing glory to God in the highest.
To God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give. Jesus Christ, only begotten Son. Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High Jesus Christ. With the Holy Spirit in the glory of God.
Let us pray. O God, who on this day, through your only begotten Son, have conquered death and unlocked for us the path of to eternity, grant, we pray, that we who keep the solemnity of the Lord's resurrection, may through the renewal brought by your Spirit, rise up in the light of life. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. Take a seat now. Let us listen to the word of God.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter proceeded to speak and said, "You know what has happened all over Judea, beginning in Galilee, after the baptism that John preached, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and power. He went about doing good and healing all those oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses of all that he did, both in the country of the Jews and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree. This man God raised on the third day and granted that he be visible, not to all the people, but to us, the witnesses chosen by God in advance, who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commissioned us to preach to the people and testify that he is the one appointed by God as the judge of the living and the dead. To him all the prophets bear witness that everyone who believes in him will receive forgiveness of sins through his name." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endures forever.
house of Israel say, His mercy endures forever. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. The right hand of the Lord has struck with power. The right hand of the Lord is exalted. I shall not die, but live, and declare the works of the Lord. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. The stone which the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. By the Lord has this been done. It is wonderful in our eyes. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad.
A reading from the letter St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, do you not know that a little yeast leavens all the dough? Clear out the old yeast, so that you may become a fresh batch of dough, inasmuch as you are unleavened. For our Paschal Lamb, Christ, has been sacrificed. Therefore, let us celebrate the feast, not with the old yeast, the yeast of malice and wickedness, but with the unleavened bread of sincerity and truth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Of God, the Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. On the first day of the week, Mary of Magdala came to the tomb early in the morning while it was still dark and saw the stone removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and to the other disciple, whom Jesus loved, and told them, "They have taken the Lord from the tomb, and we don't know where they put him." So Peter and the other disciples went out and came to the tomb. They both ran, but the other disciple ran faster than Peter
and arrived at the tomb first. He bent down and saw the burial clothes there, but did not go in. When Simon Peter arrived after him, he went into the tomb and saw the burial clothes there, and the cloth that had covered his head, not with the burial cloth, but rolled up in a separate place. Then the other disciple also went in, the one who had arrived at the tomb first, and he saw and believed, for they did not yet understand the scriptures, that he had to rise from the dead. The Gospel of the Lord. You can take a seat now. Today, we are celebrating with happiness the victory of Jesus upon death, upon sin, and his victory is also our victory, because we are the Christians, we are the one, the followers of Jesus. From this generation, 2020, 21, and what, since we are born, we are the new generation of the people of God, and with Jesus, we are victorious upon death. And then Easter is our celebration of Jesus' victory, but our victory with him. And it's interesting to see some things, some aspects here. Let me put it in the right page. Of the readings from this day, when we can see in the first reading, we can see the attitude of Peter. Do you remember Peter? How scared he was when Jesus was taken by the guards, betrayed by Jude, and when he was being tortured. And then the guys, when he saw Peter, oh, you are one of them. No, I don't. I even know him. He denied Jesus 3 times. Why? Why? He was afraid. He saw what happened with Jesus. And certainly, in his fear, he thought, oh my gosh, they are going to do the same with me. He was afraid for his life. He was afraid for his life. And then he denied Jesus 3 times. But what happened? That after some days, we can see Peter totally different. Actually, from the Acts of the Apostles, it was not just some days after that, but some time after that, what happened that Peter now is not afraid anymore? He's openly talking about Jesus. And not just openly talking about Jesus, he's even saying the one who put them to death. The guys who put him to death, the Jews people, the leaders of the people, he's not afraid anymore. Why? Because he could see, as we could listen in the gospel here, could see and understand that Jesus is risen. Jesus has authority and power upon death. Death has no power anymore upon Jesus. And then, certainly he got to that point when he was like, what I was afraid of. Like if he's saying to himself, hello, what I was afraid of. He won the death, and I am one of his followers. And then with him, I am victorious upon death. No afraid anymore. Now he talks openly about Jesus. Now he announces and denounces and he preached the mercy of Jesus to all the one who accept that good news of the Lord and who want to be part of that project. And then, with Jesus, we are victorious upon that. His victory is our victory too. And then this is what we are celebrating today. And I can tell you, look around, look outside. It is not just a celebration of us. Even heavens, the angels, the saints, God himself is celebrating with us. Look what a beautiful day he gave to us today. Sunny day, very blue sky. Oh my gosh, perfect to celebrate Pascha. Perfect to celebrate Easter. And then we are rejoicing. We are happy to celebrate the reason of our faith. But Let us look a little bit here in the gospel too. We will see Peter again. But interesting, the moment when Mary Magdalene, she goes there to, well, certainly to be around Jesus, to follow their traditions. And she sees that the tomb is open and she doesn't know what to do. And then she goes and she was the first one announcing to the others that Jesus was risen. He was not there. Actually, in that moment, she even realized that yet. Some of the other Gospels, they put that situation from other perspectives, what is interesting. But the point is, she was the first one who got there and who brought that good news to the other disciples. And them, the other disciples, they shared with us. And now, it is our turn. With our life, with our faith, to celebrate the victory of Jesus and to announce that to the yesterday when we did the celebration of lighting the Easter candle, that was something beautiful to see while Deacon Paul was walking with the Easter candle. He would sing Christ light of the world, and Father Jack would share from a candle the fire with the people in the corner here of the seats. And they would share the fire with the others. And from where I was, I could see like if the light of God, light of Jesus was walking like in both sides, in both directions. Huh? They were sharing the light of Jesus. And that is the point of our faith, to share with other the light of Jesus. And then today, we are celebrating the resurrection of our Lord and Savior. And we are invited to share His good news, His light, His bless, His grace with the world around us. And then, from now on, we are invited, like intimated, by Jesus, to go and to share this in our ambient of life. Family, work, school, neighborhood, wherever we go, to announce more than just with words, but with our actions, with our attitudes. There is the right place to share what we believe in, the light of Jesus, the blessed love and mercy of God. Amen? And today also, we have the opportunity of renewing our faith. Just for it, I would like to invite you to stand. We will do the renewal of our baptismal promises. I'll be asking some questions and you answer, I do. Dear brothers and sisters, through the Paschal mystery, we have been buried with Christ in baptism, so that we may walk with Him in newness of life. And so, now that our Lenten observance is concluded, let us renew the promises of holy baptism, by which we once renounced Satan and his works, and promised to serve God in the Holy Catholic Church. So, I ask you, do you renounce Satan and all his works, and all his empty show? Do you renounce sin? Do you renounce the lure of evil, so that sin may have no mastery upon you? Do you renounce Satan, the author and prince of sin? That is good, to renounce, to show what we are giving up because of Jesus. But it's important also to us to express what we believe in. So, I will ask some questions to you about our faith. Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father?
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting? People of God, this is our faith. We are happy to profess in Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And now, as a continuation of this rite of renewing our baptismal promises, I will be walking around you and sprinkling you with holy water. In this while, we are going to have a song, isn't it? I'll go this way first and then that way.
Baptized in water, sealed by the Spirit, cleansed by the blood of Christ our King, heirs of salvation, trusting in water, sealed by the Spirit, dead in the tomb with Christ our King, one with his rising.
One thing beautiful, one thing that I think is beautiful and we bless the people of God, that as you, I think you always saw that when we have this ritual of blessing, the priest never blesses himself before or after this ritual. But do you see? Because I blessed you, I am blessed too. And then that is what we bring to life. When we bless, we are blessed. Huh? What we give, we receive.
Well, let us take a seat now. We professed our faith and then... Oh, actually, this is the moment of the prayer of the faithful, isn't it?
Yes.
And then... Sorry, let us stand. Let us present to the Lord our prayers with confidence, because we know He always listens to us.
For all the newly baptized, that they may faithfully follow Jesus, grow in their love for God, and keep the light of Christ burning brightly in their lives, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all children, that God will keep them safe from all harm, help them to grow and develop their gifts, and celebrate the gift of life each day Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all believers, that Christ will pour out the Spirit upon us and enable us to continue the mission of bringing hope, meaning, and love to all in our society, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For healing of hearts and relationships, that the risen Lord will open the path to reconciliation and healing amongst families, communities, and nations, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace, that the risen Lord will give each of us peace of mind and heart, relief from stress and pressure, and renew our spirits so that we may live life fully each day, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the deceased members of St. Mary Parish for whom today's Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. For peace all over the world, particularly we ask for the end of the war of Russia against Ukraine. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the personal intentions we have in our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a fast and efficient cure for COVID and all its variants, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And let us show our thankfulness to our God for so many good things He does for us, saying together, thank you, Father.
Thank you, Father.
Almighty Father, listen to our prayers. And attend the eyes if it is your will. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. You can take a seat now. Now this is the moment of offertory.
Our offertory hymn is number 691 in your Breaking Bread issue. The Lord is my light, number 691.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that your sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Exultant with paschal gladness, O Lord, we offer the sacrifice by which your church is wondrously reborn and nourished, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times, to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this day, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb, who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying he has destroyed our death, and by rising restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers, with the angelic hosts, sing together the unending hymn of your glory, as they acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving you thanks, he broke the bread, said the bless, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." People of God, the mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread, proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Sean, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us, how we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her blessed spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and the honor is yours, forever and ever. Let us pray like Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously, grant peace in our days that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Lord, look not on our sins, but on the faith of our church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Yes, so, with a beautiful smile, perfect this one. With this smile, let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace with you. Peace with you. Peace with you. People of God, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof.
but only say the word, and my soul shall be. May the body and blood of Christ bring us to the everlasting life. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Our communion hymn is number 568 in your Breaking Bread issue. The Strife is O'er, number 568.
The body of Christ.
Second communion hymn is number 170, Ye Sons and Daughters, number 170.
Alleluia.
Let us pray. Look upon your church, O Lord, with unfailing love and favor, so that renewed by the Paschal mysteries, she may come to the glory of the resurrection. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Father Jack asked me to reinforce the announcement that we have these books at all the doors, okay? It's a gift, and then you can take one for you, or even more if you want to give it to someone else. It is 365 Days of Inspiration, The Wisdom of Fulton Sheen, with an introductory by Matthew Kelly. Well, anyway, it's a good book to help you guys in our reflection, to live our faith, to reinforce our knowledge about God during the year. Okay, and then take as a gift from the parish for you, and if you want to take some more to give to someone else, go for it. It's a way also of announcing, helping, being light, and sharing the light. Am I forgetting something? People of God, the Lord be with you. By the intercession of the Holy Spouses, Mary and Joseph, may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace to serve the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia. And happy Easter.
Our closing hymn is number 169 in your Breaking Bread issue. Alleluia, Alleluia, number 169.